Hello, everybody. Welcome back. This is going to be week number 5 of stage 3 of Quake Pro League. I'm Ketchup and I'm joined by Lethal today for the broadcast. It's going to be some two fan favorites going head to head right now. Sparty versus Toxic is our next matchup. And it's always great, actually, watching both these two players go head to head. Sparty is. He's had some pretty decent results in stage 3. It's got to be said, you know, last week, taking it 2-1 over Cooler was a massive result for a player like Sparty, who in stage 1 was a bit of a slow burner, I suppose. He was unfortunately relegated by CNZ at the stage 1 finals. Was able to get his revenge at the stage 2 finals in quite dramatic fashion, it's got to be said, if anyone remembers that series. But now he's back into stage 3. I think he's really been kind of proving his worth, for a lack of a better term. And he's had some very up and down results, but he's had some good ones in the mix as well. Toxic, I mean, he is kind of like Mr. Execution, Mr. Aim, Mr. Movement. You know, if it involves his two hands and it's hard, he'll probably be really good at it, right? That's the general gist of Tox when he plays Quake. And hard to call out of these two players, honestly. It's a bit of a sort of like homeland showdown between the two as well. And I don't know, Lethal, what do you think?
Yeah, the two Swedish powerhouses. Now, everything you said about Sparty, true, couldn't agree with you even more. He's been looking really good and really strong. So don't get me wrong, I feel like every time these two have played against each other, Tox has had his number, or I don't know, there's maybe some kind of like nation pride like between the two of these players to see like who's the better one. But yeah, Tox has always had his number. He's like, I think the last time they played, it was like 3-0 in favor of Tox. So Sparty maybe at the time wasn't grinding as much. But if I go on any Quake streamer and I'll see Sparty playing against him, always matching against him, always scrimming against him all the time, constantly. And I think Sparty's always been really good. Even way, way back in the day up to now, he's always had the skill, the barrier, like he's always up there, like around tier 1 constantly. It's just a matter of, it would he show himself on form or not. But Sparty has been on form consistently throughout the whole course of this stage. But Tox fell off a little bit, not going to lie, even at the beginning of the stage. And I said a couple of weeks ago when he played against Razy, he lost 2-1. But before that match, I said he needs to show the performance he normally shows in previous matches in the past, like quite a while ago, till this Razy matchup. And I thought, even if he loses, if he keeps the scores close, that it shows he was on form. And yes, he was on form. He really showed that he, what he's made of at this point. Even though he lost 2-1 to Razy, the scores were quite close, I think, apart from one, which was like Crop to Keep, but that's one of Razy's better maps anyway. I think everyone knows it by now. It's kind of like his playground. But Tox has been looking really good the last couple of weeks, but he needs to continue to show that form. And if he doesn't, Sparty could be in with a chance, but we'll have to see how things pan out.
Well, we have the picks and bans. Awoken, Molten Falls, and Ruins of Sarnath is going to be the selection. We have Galena versus Doomslayer. Very meta picks for that first map. Molten Falls, quite exciting, actually. Potentially Anarchy versus Slash. So that's going to be... normally, you'd see it the other way around if it's Tox, but he's proven time and time again that he's just as talented on the Anarchy all the same. And then Ruins of Sarnath, Ison, and BJ. So it's actually not as high octane as we normally see from Tox. I know movement is kind of like his key. That is what one of his most dangerous areas can be, is that rapid fire champion selection. But he isn't shy of picking those more traditional champions, because if he just has really good aim and puts himself in good positions, he can just be a nightmare to go up against. Sparty is always one of those more kind of like underratedly smart players. He does think very mechanically. It's why he's always held in such high esteem. And as long as Quake Champions has been competitive, Sparty's been a name that you see later in a bracket, you know, the online qualifiers for all the dream hacks and all the Quake cons back in the day. Sparty was always like right up there. You'd see him in those later areas for a good reason. He's just consistently damn good. But between these two players, it's going to be really a game of smarts versus high execution, as is normally the way with Tox. He does prove consistently that he can make those really interesting plays and he can think outside the box, but he can sometimes be his own worst enemy when it comes to, you know, should I do this? Should I do that? Putting himself in bad positions sometimes, or sticking around one rail too long. I've always said it can sometimes be a bit tricky being a Tox fan, like a mental note, because he'll have an amazing map and it's his. He just needs to take it. And then just one wrong decision goes like catastrophically wrong. And before you know it, Tox is out. And it's like, oh, he had it. What happened? So I don't know. It's hard to call this one, Harry. I think it is. But it's going to be a testament to how stage three is shaping things up to be different, as it always tends to be.
Yeah, if you are a Tox fan, you're right. It's potluck. What are you going to get? Are you going to the on-form aggressive, like, Ainstar Tox, or is it the mediocre kind of Tox we see now and again? I'm hoping it isn't the latter, but we'll have to see what happens. But the main thing is, Vespati, for his position, he banned Bloodrun. Now, Tox has been very good on Bloodrun throughout the whole course of the season, the stage. So that's completely understandable. Vel banned. It's not one of Sparty's best maps, but now and again, he has shown a lot of improvement. So I'm not really too surprised there. But in terms of the picks and bans, Galena versus Doom, let's be real, on Awoken, that's very standard. It's very basic. We've seen it time and time again, no matter where you are. I do love the Anarchy versus Slash, but even for the last one, the Aizen on Ruins. Now, I can understand that you can abuse the turret by leaving it near the heavy when you try and go for the heavy here and there to have some kind of damage advantage when they push in, because you don't know where the turret's going to be, depending on if you put it in the standard default placement or not when you do pick up the heavy. But yeah, I'd be interested to see how that matchup goes and the placements of the turret and what it actually does with it.
Yeah, it's, well, Aizen's at the kind of champion where we've seen the odd map where it doesn't really work. What you understand the idea of the champion being picked for certain points of the map, but I guess, well, moments away from finding out. We're going to go extremely meta for map number one, though, going into Awoken. Toxic versus Sparty. We'll find out how both players are shaping up. They've had up and down performances. Sparty coming off the back of a very, very exciting victory against Cooler last week. We'll see if he can keep that momentum going. Let's go.
Too surprised. I'm gonna start with Tox now as he does pick up the heavy. Just a little bit, gonna leave the totem in place in one of the most default positions you normally get on the map. Just using it just to at least get a little bit of time removed with his ability. But at the moment, quite passive between both players, but Sparty does have that top mid control and Tox is dropped sadly. I don't think Sparty even expected that, but Sparty manages to push in and really finish him off. There, that rocket only on 39 HP for Tox, but as I say that, he's got that totem to really try and keep himself going a little bit more. Both stacks are very similar, but as we say, man, oh my word, Sparty's still trying to push in, but they've left each other for the time being catch up. My goodness.
The problem is Tox has been able to put himself really healthy and Sparty able to disengage and some really good tri-bolt actually returned either way. And another totem gets dropped. Tox picks up the first blood. And the thing is about this matchup is Doom. The one setback that Doom will always have is he has to concede the hourglasses. That is something that will... You trade the double jump, but never using the Berserk unless, you know, extreme circumstances. Against someone like a Galena, she's gonna have more access to those totems because the hourglasses are ripe for the picking. And now Toxic is choosing to be really aggressive, pushing down some LG coming through and some rocket damage. Additionally, Sparty's in a bad shape, and Tox, he has the right weapons. He is always well known for just when it's time for combat, it is that aim coming out. It's not all about the rail. It's pretty much everything. However, a great rocket, but a trade. This is going to come down to who gets the better spawn. Ah, Sparty. Not bad.
As you were saying that.
Both rockets and armor. Hell yeah, let's go.
Yeah, he's literally loving life at this point. You were completely right, though. Whatever spawn's going to get, it's going to definitely change the impact and the outcome of what is going to happen. And that was like... I wouldn't say a gifted spawn, but at least it was gifted to just a little bit. So at least that way he doesn't have to jump up for the rockets and delay himself by another few seconds going through the telly. But even now, though, we're sort of waiting patiently. Tox is looking at that top mid control, try and go for it. But Sparty has been hanging around them the entire time, and Tox does get a heavy. It takes a little bit of damage, but even then, Tox could possibly go for this. After that rocket, my goodness, Sparty has a getaway. It's terrible. It gets to back against the wall now, but... managed to get away nonetheless, but Tox is still after blood.
From this point, Sparty has to be very careful. He's eyeing up the armor for when he has the chance to take it. Quickly get in and out, but as long as he's able to evade, that was a really nice moment of patience there for Sparty. He knows he can't really press yet. Unfortunately, he is railable at this health. That double jump's going to have to be used to save his skin and avoid any angle he can give up. But it looks like Tox has other plans. He's going to go full speed ahead. And unfortunately for Sparty, just not able to get the damage on those rockets.
Yeah, it's not the same Sparty we normally see at this stage. We've seen a lot from him in the past, but it's just weird how every time he plays against Tox, it's not that he's playing differently. It's just, I feel like Tox Toxis has his number. It's just very strange. It's a bit peculiar. But this is his moment to try and at least change that in somehow, some way. But right now, at this point in time, Toxis stack is absolutely ridiculous. Stacked up to the eyeballs at this point in time. And right now, Spicy Rondy, everything he can. But he does some great LG work, but Toxis tries to survive as much as he can with 6 HP. This is going to be able to take this. Both players managed to get away from each other. But Tox is known for how good his LG is. I'm surprised that Sparty almost came out on top in that little engagement.
It was that last little burst. That last burst of LG just failed to hit its mark at all. It saved Sparty's skin. It didn't give him a frag, though. Both players able to disengage. And again, it constantly comes back to the fact that the totems are going to be way more readily available. And as long as Tox controls the heavy more so than the mega, Galena is going to have that inherent advantage. Sparty's going to have to take out some of those totems. Is able to get one of them. Problem is, if two totems are already in play and one totem is ready to drop down, it's going to serve the same purpose as three of them being up anyway. So this is something that Sparty needs to be careful about. You have to shut down that stack from Galena. She will run rings around you if you don't.
Yeah, those totems are in a default position as well to make matters worse. So it's not like he's going to run into it. But do you know what? I was just thinking to myself, Master's Curse, he probably will after that rocket jump, but he hasn't done it anyway. But it doesn't matter. Sparty managed to pick up the mega, but Tox is still... Oh, making life a misery for him, but he's on 61 HP, 86 now. He's going to push straight through, but he's going to bait out a little bit because you're just at the right time. My word, just barely managed to get away with that. And Tox slowly but surely increases his lead once again.
It was beautiful timing for Tox to go through that teleporter because you're just trying to offset it just enough that if someone's peppering rockets down, you're kind of catching that rhythm in between. The totem did provide its stack, and he's going in. Aggression for Tox, but unfortunately not able to hit the mark. Sparty punishing that rocket jump massively, and there is all the time to come back. You know, this has been a dominant map for Tox so far, but you know, we just hit the 5-minute warning. Sparty doesn't have a lot of work to do in terms of frags.
Sparty's got a huge stack, but with Doom he's got the mobility to try and make something happen, but not if Tox is railing like this. Two in a row is going to go straight in with that LG, but he does have the heavy as well. Just to make matters worse, compliment him further, and he's now going to try and make a protection for the Mega, but it looks like Sparty won't really be too much of a challenge here. Oh, as I say that, Tox just managed to get it anyway. He wanted to bait out a little bit longer, which is understandable. I will not. But as he put that totem down, my word, what a rail. Tox is trying to go for a second if he can, but will he be able to catch him? Oh, he just barely doesn't, but the try bolt from Sparty, that was a great play from him to capitalize on that situation. Tox should not have lost that bout.
But these are the kind of risks that Toxic is known for making. And it really is very much kind of like a for better or worse kind of scenario, because the reality is he didn't have to go for that rail angle. You know, he was, the consequences of missing that rail was a tri-ball. And even if he hit the rail, they probably would have traded anyway. But Tox is the kind of player that if he truly believes that he can get that frag, he can get that execution or that clutch rail when he needs to, he's not shy of going for it. It's just the downside is, if it's highly risky, doesn't quite work out either. It's the extreme ups and downs, but that is a punish. And there's the rocket just shy of hitting its target. Mega's about to spawn. Sparty looked a little bit like he couldn't decide whether he wanted to stick around or retreat, and he got caught in no man's land making the choice.
Yeah, that LG was madness. He flew up in the air. It was a one-way trip. Sally to his death, but now what can he do? He's got 3 minutes left remaining. Sparty's looking pretty good in the stack, but he's got to try and force something out here, which he does try and do. But Tox is looking quite good about LG, and sadly for Sparty, Tox managed to clean things up. Sparty really needed to try and win that fight. Decided to go for the rockets, try and switch it up, but didn't really help him nonetheless. But this could be a time for him to try and do something. But Tox is rails again, just being an absolute pain. And my word, again, another lovely place rail by Tox.
Talk about the time to land those insanely clutch shots. Doesn't hit the last two, but at this point, does it really matter? The important ones were landed. Sparty, a really bad time to get caught by LG when he'd used his double jump. So there's no way he could avoid that juggle. And guaranteed rocket. Dominant way to finish this map, and at this point should be a map won. Sparty uses Berserk, flies through the air. Oh no, yeah, oh yeah. No, Sparty.
Yeah,
that was very much, I'm dead, and I'm not going to give you the satisfaction. Peace out, yeah. Homie.
Do you know what? Yeah, I have to frag. I'd rather respawn quicker and do, you know, a better job. It's completely understandable, but my goodness, Tox, I feel like he's trying to give me a cardiac arrest sometimes. Like, with some of the rail shots he does, the basic ones he misses, but the really difficult ones, he makes it look like it's child's play at this point. It's absolute madness, but somehow just barely missed that rail, misses the second one as well. But I don't think it matters at this point. A minute 20 left, he's going to clean up. Yes, he does, a small amount of health to keep him going a little bit further. And he's up 13-3. Too little, too late for Sparty. A little bit of humour as well to the, towards the end of things, but it just wasn't to be for Sparty. We'll have to see how he does in number two.
Absolutely. I mean, this is going to be just a minute of Tox showing off, I think, if anything. Oh. Yeah, there you go. Case in point. But fundamentally, it's just Tox very aggressive, pretty much from the starting point. The moment this map began, it was crazy good accuracy, important rails. The use of the LG, very important. Especially going up against Doomslayer, you need to make sure you're using LG kind of like as your priority, I suppose. Yeah, he's definitely just trying to get some flicks here for the highlight reel. And Sparty's just not even interested in fighting anymore.
He just wants to be in the top plays, doesn't he?
He just wants to be number one.
Yeah, that's understandable.
People, what a show off.
Yeah, I know. Oh. How dare you? How dare you show off?
How dare you be good? How rude of you to be good at the game.
Oh, but yeah, 20 seconds left remaining. I'm glad we are seeing this version of Tox, but as I say, but it cleans him up nicely, 18-3 now. But I'm so glad to see this version of Tox on numerous occasions. I don't like it when I see 1 week he could be playing extremely well and could fall off like the following week. It's just, it really aggravates and annoys me. But at this time around, two or three weeks on the trot, I know, but it's just frustrating sometimes. But it's glad to see him playing in his top form again and again, week by week on a weekly basis. But you saw there, damage-wise, over 1,800 more compared to Sparty. He's really showing what he's made of here. And it's just, you know, it's just beautiful to see him play Awoken.
It always is. And it was a great little introduction. And as always, just a reminder of the strength of Tox. Sparty, unfortunately for Sparty, did try and push into, from like an early point, an early lead was kind of given to Tox at a point where Tox is hitting all of his shots. He's punishing insanely hard. And then at the same time, Sparty's taking a lot of risks. Sparty was taking a lot of risks through the sort of mostly lying in the pickups. Quite a few of those early frags took place around Mega, where Sparty's there to try and establish. Sometimes it works. Most of the time it didn't. And from that point, the second Tox had crazy momentum. It was just, Sparty was just pushed off the map and really wasn't able to establish anything at all. Molten Falls is going to be next. I'm interested in this pick purely on the basis of its Anarchy versus Slash. So it's going to be crazy rapid fast. Sparty's going to be the one rocking the crouch slider, though. And it's going to be Anarchy on the side of Tox rocking the air movement. I don't know how to make this one, to be honest. If Tox is hitting the shots like he has been on Awoken, I'm a little bit nervous for Sparty. Sparty's going to have to kind of just refresh here. It was a one-sided map one. Forget about it. He kind of has no choice point. Yeah, I don't know what you're talking about. What map? What map? This is map one, isn't it? Yeah, this is map one, isn't it? Yeah, of course.
Yeah, it's a shame to see. It's awful to see. I don't think it'll be barcoded in his mind in terms of the scoreline. He just thought, brushed it off. Okay, that's map one. Never happens. I'm going to forget that ever happened, that even existed at that stage. But Molten Falls, yeah. In terms of the champion picks for each map, it is very well balanced from what they've decided to choose from. You saw Tox went for more of a totem for the health rather than mobility. But this time around, you can see Sparty's gone for more of the mobility approach in the first two maps. So this is Sparty's map pick this time for Molten Falls. So he's got something up his sleeve clearly with the slash. I want to see what actually he can do. If the whole situation where if he gets the first frag, we'll be backing off a lot more and he come around and appear like the Houdini act he might do for the items, or if he just decides to back off momentarily and decide what he wants to do from there. But we've seen players like Dramus play a very defensive slash, but very well thought out and calculated. So will he play like that? I don't think so. It depends on how he's feeling. He probably will do if he doesn't have to stack. But even then, though, Tox is just looking just looking ridiculous at this point.
Before we load in, I've noticed, I think there might have been an error in the graphics because Sparty has gone in for Ranger as his pick, which leads me to believe that the slash was banned away. So I think there might have been a mix-up on the graphics. So it's in fact going to be Ranger Pick slash Ban, which would make a lot of sense to remove Toxic being able to play Slash in general, least of all from this map, which is one of her strongest picks. And Sparty going in with the Ranger. I'm now actually not as concerned. Now he has a little bit more beef and a bit more damage. So apologies there for the confusion. It must have been a graphics thing. I can only assume. But either way, this is going to be a matchup for Sparty that I instantly now kind of favor him a little bit more in.
Well, everything I said about Slash for the last minute, ignore. Never happens. Just like what happened in map
yeah, what are you talking about? This is map number one, isn't it?
Exactly, yeah. Everything said about Slash in map number one didn't exist, never happened. So we'll just move on from that anyway. But as we go back into the match, Tox already up 1-0 in the series. And we'll have to see what Sparty can do. So it doesn't have the mobility, but does have the orb to try and capitalize in certain scenarios, as well as for damage. But Sparty looking very healthy here. But Tox needs to just play it cool. It does have the first frag, which may be a little bit of a nuisance, Sparty, depending on what kind of scenario he's placed in. The inject will come in. He's going to try and at least test that rail. Doesn't do too much of it. Expects him to do the rocket jump. And my word, the LG barely misses the rail. Both players missing it back and forth. But Tox is showing that aggression a little bit more, but decides to back off and fight for another day.
Risky business for Tox to push while firing the rail, because if that rail obviously did miss its mark, he was still carrying that momentum forward. So that could have been a massive punish there from Sparty, but understandably he's focused on retreating, doesn't want to give too much up. But Tox, that was just patience from him, and the trade! Wonderful patience there. I know the first frag there technically went to Sparty, but Tox just sat there and listened. The second he knew the rocket was ready to play. Speaking of rockets, what are these rockets? Sparty just can't even move.
Got the heavy on spawn, great rockets just to make things matters worse. What else can you do here? As the Mega will come out any second now, and he does drop for it, but Tox does have the inject. But Sally isn't to be, as Sparty comes out on top of that little bout.
That was some crucial rocket fire being returned there from Sparty. But a good spawn from Tox. LG. If Tox spawns near the LG and he's got nothing else to work with, it almost feels like sometimes you just need to display that this extra layer of respect, because Tox's LG is insane. And just like that, you just click your fingers and he's gone. Tox had only just spawned and Sparty had armor, he had stack, and right again, oh no, he's off. And Tox knows he can't get away. Dire Orb was ready, but what a waste it would have been. Sparty knows there's no point losing the cooldown.
Yeah, what's the point if you're on 29 HP? You might as well just leave it be, save the orb for another fight, maybe get the trade off. But Tox's LG rail is just disgusting. And again, Tox coming in with that LG. Sparty, it's not that he's giving room to breathe. He's just running out of options and ideas on what he can do. The inject does come out. Don't think it matters anyway.
Oh my God, that rail wasn't even necessary, Harry.
No, it wasn't. And then finish things up anyway. Even if it was on 20 HP. But he's like, you know what? I'm that confident in my aim right now. I can just ray you off. So I think his gun skill at this point and his mentality with it is just through the roof.
Just dab on him like the haters. But in this situation, if you're Sparty, so we clearly have the information that this is Tox online, right? This is the Toxic that we know that we're dealing with. So if you're in Sparty's position, okay, well, what? Do you just not give up a single rail angle and let him control the entire map? You just have to let him now run the circuit. Sparty, you got to feel a bit lost in this position, because if you're now against a Tox that does not miss the shots, that makes every single rail count, every rocket juggles you into death. Like, Sparty now, he's trying to get the Mega, but it was so awkward for him to even get in and out without giving up a guaranteed rocket. He is going to be aggressive now, though. Is this going to be enough? The LG is just so good. And the missed rail does manage to hit the second rail, but it's not enough. If he just hit the first one, Tox would have gone down. But because he missed, he's punished again. 8-2. Tox looking so good today.
Yeah, that could have been a completely different story there. And even though this isn't Tox's map pick, he loves playing Anarchy. He said it time and time again. It is one of his, not just better, but one of his favorite champions. So it kind of balances out a little bit more for him. But even at this stage, what can Sparty do? Every time he's had a decent stack, somehow, some way, Tox is about to come through. Ooh. That tri-bar did so much damage. That's ridiculous. And the rail to make these matters worse. But even then, Sparty's still trying to fight back and fake out the orb. But it wasn't to be, as Tox is all over him. His tri-bars are just ridiculous at this point. I thought his rail and LG was bad enough. My word. Tox is just trying to figure him out.
The danger is also that Sparty lost his Dire Orb to go for that play. So he's going to have no escape option here. He has to rely on his own guns, which actually might happen. He's getting some decent damage, but it's returned swiftly. by Tox. Needs to get... Oh, give me a bit of motion sickness there with his mouse. But, oh, okay, this is an opportunity. Spotty gets some crucial damage. But this is Anarchy. That movement makes him ever so hard to chase down. The danger is that Spotty's got to make a pretty solid read on where Tox is going to retreat. Spotty has got the stack to work with. The danger is that there are so many different avenues. Oh, he's looking for a drive-by rail. Oh, dear. Spy would have been punished a lot heavier if he wasn't Ranger, thanks to Ranger's self-damage passive. But this is quite tricky because like Tox was put down and he has to disengage and restack. Thing is, 5.5 minutes in, Tox has a massive lead to work with. He can totally afford to do that. Sparty is the one that he's got full control. And he has both items, sure, but he has 6 frags to go. And that's on the understanding that Tox doesn't get a frag along the way, which is very likely with how he's been aiming so far.
Yeah, it's very difficult for him, especially with the mobility of Anarchy. Right now, Spartan needs to treat this map like an ice cream scoop. He's got to try and at least scoop it away to a position where he's got one part of the cover of the map, like a third or a quarter, and then just walk, play it passively and slow, and then try and catch more guard. But it looks like Tox is actually the one doing that instead. And the LG looked amazing, but it wasn't to be, as Sparty does manage to clean up, gets to heavy. This could be his time to try and make some kind of comeback. But again, Tox runs straight out, straight into him again once more. And Sparty looking very good now, back-to-back frags. But is it enough? What will Tox do differently? He is playing a passive route for the rest of this match. But even then, he needs to continue to try and contest some of these items. But even if he doesn't win those fights, Tox can still nicely get away.
Well, some of these immediate frags, and speaking of which, this might even be another one. The glass cannon aspect of Anarchy does start to shine through, where he is one of the most rapid champions, sure, but much easier to take him out. You know, if you're hitting his shots, he is quite a flimsy champion in terms of general stack. But LG, Sparty goes down. Looks like he was caught swapping weapons right there. I'm almost sure I heard a click.
He was 75 and 15 as well. He actually was really put in a perfect kind of sense, but sadly couldn't get the rail out in time. But the LG from Tox still looking phenomenal to be.
Oh my god.
Gets out the MG anyway, cleans him up nicely, and Tox is on a good stack, good balance now, with only 2.5 minutes left, and Sparty still needs to find 6 frags. It's, again, like I mentioned before, not impossible, but my word, it's looking that way, as luck's not looking too much in his favour. Tox goes to once again, nice little ult to get behind him, but is it actually enough? The inject comes through, beats him off with the shotgun, will he be able to? Sparty's so weak at this point, so my word, just barely managed to get a mega to stay alive, and Tox is still over him, but they've decided to not continue the fight.
Yeah, the spread was not Toxic's friend in that situation. Some beautiful tri-ball, though. Enough to make Sparty a bit more tender. Of course, he has to chase now. He only has 2 minutes and he has 6 frags. He kind of has to go all in. And Tox is just going to play around that. The defensive tri-ball. I love the use of it. I really love the use of it. Ranger, he has some of the more linear movement if he's not got access to the dire orb. He has to make something happen. He's got to chase Tox. That's an easy angle and that's an easy placement of the tri-ball. He has no, my word. Oh, that was going to be some style. If he landed that, the backwards movement just to chase it down. Tri-ball. Sparty disappears. And again, it's down to the fact that Sparty has to try and do something. I mean, this map is already lost. There's too much work to do, but you know, he's not going to give up, is he? Rockets for days. And again, we're going to get just over a minute of showing off now, I think, at this point. We're at that point again. It's that time again, kids. How many fires can you get? Well, the first one's going to go to Sparty, but he's weak now, right? That's the danger. He's weak, and it should be an easy pickup. Hang on, there's some tri-ball. Oh no, misses the rail! And the second one. Oh dear. Sparty, there's some difficult rails, mind you. Definitely difficult ones, but painful ones to miss.
Yeah, he tried nonetheless, which is the main thing. But it's funny, because with the tri-ball, going back to it earlier, normally you get a little bit of damage done, but it's more for, you know, feeding info to yourself, or just keeping them at bay. But the amount of damage he was getting done was just ridiculous. And he's a very skinny person who gets to call it out anyway. Oh, get on. Give it a rest. Give it a rest. Surely not. It's just going to... Okay, it's going to leave him beat anyway, which is a little bit strange, but takes him out. I think he's just taking the mickey a little bit.
That was... I thought he lagged out the way he stopped moving like that. Well, if you're not going to jump off the ledge, then I'm going to stop playing. Oh, wait, no.
Oh, no, you're right.
Did he accidentally hotkey or something? What happened?
I'm not sure.
No.
He saw the gauntlet anyway, but we'll have to confirm that.
But he left. Mm. But he left the match. I mean, Sparty
He's not wrong.
He's not wrong. The match wasn't finished. We need to consult the admin about that. That would, I mean, I got to say and go on record and say that would be possibly the most unfortunate. What happened?
Well, okay, you can see they were both messing around and all that bits and pieces.
Yeah,
but you can tell. But yeah, exactly. But it doesn't matter what kind of, in terms of mentality, like how you're feeling, if you're just around or whatever towards the end. The rules are the rules, and you've got to stick by them.
I do wonder what this means, because technically it was a match interruption, right? That the map wasn't finished and Tox left.
And Sparty did say rematch as well on top of it.
I don't know whether... I'm going to check the chat. This is the different thing about being at home, that we could actually literally consult the player chat and find out what happened.
Yeah, this is what I like as well. At least we can get to grips of exactly what is going on. But we haven't seen too much as of yet. I think they're probably discussing it, I'm assuming, with the
admins. If Tox can get back online, maybe his internet very well might have gone down, for all we know.
That is true. So,
I'm sure we'll find out soon. But I'll tell you what. Yeah, I know. I'm just, before I continue, but I think I know what you're going to say.
No, yeah, you know, well, do I even need to say it? I think I probably will anyway. But imagine if he was able to have a rematch and Tox couldn't come back and he won the series 2-1.
It would be, I think that would be possibly the most unfortunate disconnect we've ever seen in Quake Pro League. But I guess that's the nature. I mean, we can sit here in theory craft all day, or we can obviously wait for what actually happened. I'm sure we'll find out soon from an admin or someone similar, but okay, cool. So we've just been informed, discussing this with admin. We're going to find out what happens. But I mean, the fact of the matter is Tox was dominating that map to the point where he was trolling at the end. I thought he lagged out, but we thought he's trolling Sparty to the point where he's just stopping. All right, Toxic has returned. Man, I really want to know what happened there. But if the reality is, the map wasn't finished, right? So we'll find out soon, but that will suck. That will be a hard pill to swallow.
Yeah, because you got to remember, like, there was, what, 15 seconds left remaining, 20 seconds left remaining. He had like a 10 frag lead. Normally you would think, surely he should be allowed to have the win. But depending on what's said in the rule book, it depends on the circumstances. The admins will be letting us know very shortly, just having a discussion to make sure that everything's kosher. Well, but for now, though, yeah, it'll be a weird one. It'll be very, very unfortunate if, because there's 15 seconds left remaining and there's a 10 frag difference, they have to do a rematch. It would be a bit of a shame, but then again, it is what it is. But we'll find out very soon.
Well, I know in the lobby, both players, it looks to me like in the lobby, both players have sort of like prepared their picks. But we're just waiting for what actually goes on. There are so many variables that we could chat about this kind of thing for hours. But before we go into whatever is happening next, whether it's going to be map 2 or just map 3. Okay, cool. So it has been confirmed. We're going to a map 3. I believe it was both players agree was the ruling for that. So what we can actually take... So I'm keeping this in my mind as we go. So what has happened is we are going to a map 3. It was determined that there was a 0% chance that comeback by Sparty could happen because there was 30 seconds left. It was 15-6. The map was over. So by both players agreeing to it, we are going to a final map. And now we know that, we can go to... we can talk about what actually happened there. And what actually happened on that map was Tox again. It was just the accuracy and how it completely transforms the map the second Tox is hitting every single shot that he needs to hit. Because when that happens, it's just, well, what do you do? Do you just don't look at him? If you're not looking at him, he's running around taking all the items and you just try not to get hit. Like, it changes how you have to approach it.
I love how you've like used the analogy of it's like Medusa in some way. Like you just always trying to
Tox
avoid.
Will turn you to stone, mate. Don't look at him. Don't look at him. It can never be played. Don't even look at it.
Oh my goodness! But no, you are right. It's very difficult to say the least. It's more the fact of he's got to try and catch him off guard, and a guy like Tox isn't someone who you'll catch off guard. He is the one who'll be the one you'll catch off guard. The only way you can at least do that is if he's being too aggressive and the speed and mobility is going too fast, you can catch them with DLG. I saw that on three different occasions where you saw Tox is probably going at least like 450, 550 kind of speed area, going back and forth, looking for Sparty. And Sparty will go, oh, hello. And then I caught him off guard. And then managed to at least be able to take him down a few times. But, you know, if the scores were a lot closer, Tox wouldn't have made those silly little mistakes. He's just taking some risks here and there to increase his lead, which, fair enough, he can do. But with the next map being Ruins, you know, with the Aizen, I said it before, what will Tox do? I assume that he's going to be abusing the turret in the heavy area and some other bits and pieces here and there. But Sparty really needs to get something going. Because even before the series, I said normally Tox has his number. But we are going to head into map number three and see if Sparty can pick up the pieces of what's left of this series.
Yeah, so now we've come to the drawing of what's happening with the map situation. We can obviously discuss that Tox has a 2-0 win versus Sparty at the very least. So this is that bonus map territory. Great for Sparty to get at least some points. But at the same time, Tox hasn't had the most amazing stage three so far. He has had some tough opponents for sure, but that doesn't really change the fact that he's not got a lot of points in this stage. And a 3-0 victory would be a great way to get back up on form.
You know, when you get some players can have like their nemesis opponent where they just can't really get out of their mind, or they just, no one else has a struggle with them. You can beat them, but you just can't beat the same person again and again. Yeah, it's like a demon in your mind, absolutely right. But I feel like Sparty still has this issue, and it's I wouldn't even say it's a blip, it's just a bit of a tough nut to crack, really. But we'll have to see if we can at least get a map back somehow, some way. But so far, watching Tox is looking pretty good at this point in time. He's trying to flank around left and right to try and keep him at bay. But Sparty just having a little bit of trouble here. Tox keeping that height advantage and keeping that mega control.
Ooh, Sparty was trying to be careful at the start of things, but Tox, I mean, Tox being Tox, just the moment he wants to just explode on you, decided that was the right time to do it. And Spy was looking for a rail angle, but again, a very full speed Tox. He's going so fast around these corners that it is overwhelming to Sparty. You've kind of seen how he's reacting to the fight, that it's just right in his face. And it does force, like, if you have a rail out at a wrong time and you just fire instinctively, right? The downtime in between shots is more than enough for Tox to just melt the health away. And while Sparty's trying to be careful, he's giving up all these shots. And at the same time, Tox is just running rampant around the map. Sparty just looking like a deer in headlights right now.
Yeah, Sparty's looking very troubled at this point. Both of these players, it's a little bit slow here and there. But even then, what I love about Tox in this Aizen is the fact that you normally see the Aizen used maybe on Cut to Keep or maybe Awoken in some circumstances where they'll try and use the turret to either tank damage or feed themselves info, and it does a little bit of damage. But as I say that, he was literally tanking those turret shots constantly and got taken down in the end. But Tox isn't using it to take the damage. He's actually using these turrets pre-placed in different areas of the map where it may give out a little bit of damage, sure, but Tox is getting so much info, and with his aggression, it's adding a lot more, I wouldn't say effort, but just helps him a lot more with it in terms of where he wants to go and how he wants to flank things out.
I'm a little bit nervous about Sparty. I fear that he might be a little bit on autopilot with how he's playing, purely on the basis that that turret frag that we just saw was fresh off the spawn. Sparty picks up the SSG, gets pinned by the turret, and just doesn't even factor that Tox might be nearby. Like, without thinking, he goes straight for the SSG in the turret. While he's on cooldown in between the shot, he gets hit by a rail and the turret finishes him off. It's almost like this level of, well, there's a turret, shoot the turret, rather than, you know, obviously in Duel, there's so many layers to it. You're worried about where, you know, okay, the turret's here and making noise. Is Tox nearby? Did you hear that? Like, there's a couple of instances where Sparty's just getting really checked here by Tox, who's running rings around him. Sparty has got a decent stack, but I am nervous about how things are going so far. It just doesn't look like Sparty. It doesn't look like the Sparty that we've seen in this stage.
Yeah, completely agree. From what you said earlier, it depends. Like, you know, autopiloting, a lot of players do that during scrims or when they're just playing casually. But the last thing you want to do is to do it in a tournament situation.
Nice.
But as you saw there, Sparty with a lovely frag there with the rail. Could be a start of things to come. Avex done it before against Kilson, where he almost make an absolutely ridiculous comeback down from 11-1. So Sparty could equally do the same. But as I say about Tox, gets to trade. He's so desperately needed and managed to come back there. Oh my word, another rail there from Tox. Gets another one down and just making matters worse here. 8-1 in favor of Tox. My goodness.
No escape under any circumstances. It's difficult for Sparty. And again, just... it's kind of what I talked about earlier. See turret, destroy turret. Tox nearby destroys you while you destroy turret. It is the benefit of Ison, mind you. That sort of 2v1 factor. Similar to a Strog and Pika where you're just distracted by something else. You're not shooting at the player. And just return fire all the time. Tox running the circuit around the map. There's a huge delay in between Heavy and Mega. And Tox, he's not even interested. He is not even interested in taking the Heavy immediately. He knows the spawn is there. He knows he can get a refrag, get some rail damage. Even if he doesn't get a frag, go back and get the Heavy, and the stack difference is huge. There's still a delay in between the items. Mega's about to spawn, and Sparty, he kind of has to try and push this, but Tox is in a way better position to fight for it. Here we are. Here we go again. Tox is just denying every ounce Sparty has. And it's just... nothing's working out for him at this stage. A disaster map for Sparty and a miracle map for Tox. It's just this whole series has been the toxic show.
His turret placements, I'm just watching it as we go by. It's really good, and it seems like Sparty's always caught off guard. And I suppose I can see why he chose Ison for this map, but it's actually very clean, much cleaner than I expected. I thought it'd be a little bit of trouble. Maybe he's just going to use it to try and get the items. But feeding himself info all the time, Sparty is continuously distracted throughout the entire game.
No, that is,
quite surprised by that.
That is the key word. I assume we've been watching a lot of Tox as he's the one that's been winning. I've been watching a lot of Sparty because I've been very curious to see how he's trying to kind of just get back up. And again, it's coming through. We've just seen the exact same thing. Sparty's maneuvering around the map and he's trying really hard to not give away his position. And there's always a turret where he least expects it. And you just use the golden word, distraction. That's what has been really paying its dues, that consistently Sparty's not ready for a turret to be where it is, impulsively tries to take it out. Toxic is already ready to pounce him while he's busy.
It's like there's a little bit of distraction. Oh my goodness, taken down by the rail of it. There's a little bit of distraction, and then there's distraction plus taking loads of damage, plus also getting killed, also giving info whilst Tox is flanking around. There's so much that's so key. I didn't realize Ison was so good on ruins, and he's definitely figured things out. Again, Tox with another lovely rail, just making matters worse. It's 15-2, and it's still like at least another 3 minutes left. And Tox has been playing a little bit more differently this time. He's been, even though his movement is still very aggressively, his shot is very careful and precise. It's not like he's rushing to do any blick shots. It's just quite chilled, but he's still aiming really well every single time, which is still good enough against Sparty. But I think at this point in time, it's too much for Sparty. There isn't enough time left. Tox may get another frag here if he has his rail on point. Has to get the first one. We get the second one. No, he doesn't, as Sparty gets one for himself anyway.
He's fighting back, but again, it comes down to how much of a divide there is in between. And there's too much work. Sparty has to really bank the rail. Does hit it, which is nice, but it's that forever unfortunate position where you're now starting to get momentum, but it's too late. Tox has way too much of a lead, really, for Sparty to be able to come back here. And Tox doesn't even need a frag at this point. Just play defensive. If you can take any of the items, make sure you do. If not, excuse me. If you do get the chance, just keep him low. Of course, Sparty to have to just try and disengage. Man, that turret, the damage right there.
I wonder if it's because Ruins is so large, but also so open, that the turret abuse is a lot more effective. He clearly has worked this out a little bit. I've seen Ison been used a couple of times, but we haven't seen it barely at all in the Pro League. And it seems like he's making great work of it. And already Tox is just making matters worse. He's now stacked up to the eyeballs once again. 16-4 now. And it's basically his playground at this point. It's just the turret placements are very good. He's not using it to tank damage. He's feeding himself info and damage throughout the entire game. There's not been one moment where the turret has just been a huge distraction. It's just been an absolute pain in the backside. And will he be able to survive this? Tox is trying to do everything he can. He knows how weak he is. The last rocket just barely misses. But even at this point, it doesn't matter. It's way too little too late. And Tox is just having a little bit of fun with him at this stage.
Yep. You talked about information from the turret. That's actually what led this entire fight right here in motion, where Tox had jumped down 1 HP, shouts, throwing down the turret right near the teleporter and then running towards Mega. All he had to do really was listen out for the turret picking up on someone, and it did. And it allowed Tox to set himself up with the right angle. And Ison, it's a good choice. And he's been using the turret. So many layers to it. Lots of time left for Tox to have a little bit more fun, but this is a done deal. Impressive victory here for Tox, putting himself back on form, and he's just looking for some swaggy rails at this point. We'll see if he can get a few more.
He's another one trying to get on top players, isn't he? Jesus, you can't make up, can you? But doesn't matter anyway. 18-4 in favour of Tox. It's not going to change too much at this point. It's just throwing the tie in just for a laugh for this play stage. But even then, though, Tox's got a decent stack. He won't be giving any more frags by the end of this map. But we have to talk about it, though. All three maps were in dominant fashion. I don't really... can remember a point in time.
Oh my god, those rocket dodges. What the hell is that?
And that's it, though. Catch up. 2 seconds left remaining. All done. 3-0 in favour of Tox. And it's nice to see Tox being as consistent as he is on form as well. Looking very dominant from what we've seen. And swung on top of that. 2,200 difference between the pair in favour of Tox.
That was an absolutely phenomenal series all the way through. Normally when you watch Tox, there is the odd map where he's not quite on that form, but all three of those maps was Tox being Tox. And Sparty just, it seemed like it was really getting to him. Just those situations where LG comes out, you blink and he's gone. If there's a rail angle, Tox was taking it. And even then, the rockets were phenomenal. Just keeping him constantly juggled into the air, all those just miracle 100s just when he needed it. And it's like we've said before, and any player that plays against Tox who's having a great game will often tell you the same thing. Is that, what do you do? What do I do? And this guy's just hitting every single shot he could possibly look for. What is your answer? You at the very least need to answer back. How many times we see someone, you have to be able to match the aim, right? So almost like match every punch in that regard. Sparty, I think, was just overwhelmed from the opening moments of the first map to the closing moments of the third. Sparty was just shocked by it. It almost seemed like just not able to climb above it. We've seen it before, and unfortunately, we've seen it again.
Yeah, it seems to be the same thing again and again. Every time these two play, Tox has his number and just seems to be able to dominate him each and every time. Even in the last 3-0 Tox had against Sparty, it was very similar. Like, you know, it's a 3-0. The score lines were quite big in comparison, and it just seemed a bit weird. And then I'm pretty certain that for Sparty, his nemesis is Tox. And it's a shame because of that, because there is players Sparty can beat that Tox hasn't done in the past, but he just can't beat Tox. He just finds it near enough in impossible. But you have to do a serious amount of research and prep to be able to at least try and figure out a way. There is weaknesses in Tox's play in terms of like the speed and mobility. He goes around different corners. If you played maybe very defensively, you can maybe have some kind of advantage and try and pick him off from there, which he did do a few times on Molten Falls. Maybe a player like a base could maybe topple him, but even then, Sparty probably has to change his play style if he wants to try and topple Tox in any way.
Yeah, and it's also fundamentally a lot of the times where it doesn't quite work is when Tox is kind of like his own worst enemy and you need to be able to punish him. But that does require Tox to sort of be not necessarily in shape. That's also one of the elements, is that when he makes those really punishing decisions or whatever it might be, it's when a game is really close and you're going blow for blow, and then one thing goes skew if, and there's enough of a small difference between the two players that you can then ascend. Thing about those three maps was, from a very early point, Tox had a huge lead. So even if he did make a crucial mistake at one point, it was never enough that it really punished him at all, because he'd done so much work from the start of the map. Sparty was behind for the whole 30 minutes we played all three maps. He was behind from the start until the end. But result wise that means that, unfortunately, Sparty stays where he is. Point wise Tox with a 3-0, massive points injection, which he needs because he was a bit of a slow starter in stage 3. But that is going to be half this broadcast done and dusted. Our next matchup, Dramas versus Chain. Don't want to miss that one. We'll be back in a few minutes time with that. This is week number 5, stage 3, Quake Pro League. Don't go anywhere.